Hi, I am Nicola de Quattro, and I'm the Head of Engineering and Innovation at Vitrociset Belgium. Today I'm going to talk about satellite navigation. A global navigation satellite system, or GNSS, is formed by a constellation of satellites like this beautiful Lego model and a ground system spread over the world. The user on the ground, like our smartphones or the navigator in our cars, receives the signal that is transmitted constantly by every satellite on the Earth, and from some specific parameters of this signal is able to determine the position on the ground. Every big countries in the world, they have their own satellite navigation system, like USA, Russia, China, Japan, India, and of course Europe with the new Galileo system. Although the process of computing the position is in practice very complex, you can imagine measuring the distance of yourself and all satellites with a rope. And from all these measurements, your navigator is able to determine your position on ground. And this is possible wherever you are, in Europe or in China, or on a mountain, on the sea, in a sunny day, or in a stormy, or in a cloudy day. The only thing that you need is to see a portion of the sky. Of course, you want the navigation to be precise enough. You don't want your navigator to bring you off-road because it told you you were in a completely different place. For this reason, the ground system plays a really critical role. It measures the quality of the signals that is transmitted by the satellites by means of antennas which are spread all over the world. And then, corrections are computed and sent periodically to the satellites. Now, of course, the GNSS in general is much more than that. Galileo, for example, the European satellite system, for example, provides services for precise timing with an outstanding precision, or supports search and rescue systems for localizing people in trouble and allow them to ask for help. Also, it supports European governments by providing services which have a very high precision for sensitive applications. Satellite navigation is nowadays very important for our daily life, and you are using it more often than you may think. Have you ever sent your location through WhatsApp? Or have you ever shared the place you are through Facebook? And have you ever wondered how Pokémon Go could know where you are and where the Pokémon are? Also, the most obvious application, there is road navigation, which allows you to visit your friends or a delivery truck driver to find your place. But we are so used to navigation with smartphones that for us, navigating with a paper map or reading the road signs to understand our position or finding the route is really a distant memory. And can you imagine what it's like to navigate in the sea, where your only reference is the stars and a paper map? Now, all ships in the world today, they use GNSS to navigate. But GNSS is very important, especially in emergency. If you are, for example, a skier and you are hit by an avalanche, or if you have lost your path through the mountains, or if your boat is broken, then navigation is the only way you have to let people know where you are so that you can be rescued. Losing the satellite navigation services for just one day would then create an enormous damage to our lives, even just losing it for one day. Of course, we cannot repair satellites, we can repair ground equipment. For this reason, all the components of the ground are constantly monitored and maintained. Every day we experiment the benefits of satellite navigation, but this is just the beginning. Now, if navigation is very precise and reliable, why should you look at your navigator and steer the wheels of your cars if you could just let it do it for you? Just relying on navigation information. The delivery of packages could happen through cars or drones without the need of a driver, directly to your home. Robots could autonomously patrol our cities for improving our safety. Now, this seems like far future, right? Actually, this is something we are really close to do. But in order to do that, we need to continue improving satellite navigation. And this is mainly for two reasons. The first one is that we would really literally put our lives in the hands of an electronic system. And this is a tremendous challenge because failure will not be an option anymore. Secondly, there are men out there which have learned how to steal our systems, how to break into our smartphones, and they could, for example, steal our packages or even really bring us off-road, just penetrating into our navigators. So these are the highest priorities today for future innovation. And I have a question for you. What about Moon and Mars then? Well, astronauts will need to navigate over the Moon and over Mars, and they would need, sooner or later, a satellite navigation system for them. And this is one of the most exciting and great challenges of the next future.